going to the theater, this was a movie that didn't make sense, something I couldn't wrap my head around, but what I could wrap my head around, what was familiar to me, was, in fact, explosions are cool. This whole movie is cool. What goes into a movie that is cool? A cool soundtrack, a cool kind of action set piece. I had to think on that. That's just how cool this movie is. But this movie is not good in the kind of like the thing where you got to wrap your head around things. You don't want to do it. Like, okay, when you go into a film, you want to understand the film, the plot, the motivations behind each characters and villains and protagonists. But the twist is here that we don't get that. We more or less spend so much time on what the heck kind of time travel we're doing. And it's inversion. Basically, you're moving backwards in time, but the only way to move backwards in time is to move backwards in time. You don't get to go, all right, beep, boop, beep, boop, 10 years in the past. No, you actually have to live out those 10 years inverted. But here's the weird part about this is our characters do go through this simulation. Not simulation so much as time travel, but he's simulating it, so he's experiencing it. So they go through this experience. The characters are great in this film. They don't really have clear motivations. It's more or less, we don't want the world to die because we live in the world. Great writing, Chris. Great writing. You spent so much time on inversion, you gave these characters some boring motivations. Thank you. But with these characters, they have interesting names. You know, we got Max, who we call Neil. Max is Kat's, one of the characters' son. But Maximilian is his name. But if you look at the end of his name, Neil is there. It's L-I-E-N at the end of Maximilian. Invert it, like inversion, haha. But thanks for that, Chris. Flips it, it's Neil. So there's one character's name. The other's name is literally the protagonist. That's what's credited as the protagonist. I love movies, but Tenet is not so much a movie as much as it is an experience. Like, if you're one of those people who like to sit and think, I mean, really think on a subject for a really long time, this is your movie. In any case, it was a fantastic film. I love the explosions. The soundtrack was awesome. I love the dynamic scene-to-scene conversations. It's very quick. It's very, you know, one to the other, to the other, to the other. It's got a very quick rhythm, so I kind of like that. I like when movies keep me in it, and that's more of a thrilling experience. So props to Christopher Nolan for giving us that kind of experience that we needed, you know, one to the other, to the other, to the other. It was fantastic as a moviegoer, and if you love action scenes and such and such and such, but if you're more or less focusing on the plot, the story, you're gonna have to think a lot about that and learn to appreciate the little details that'll give you the full overarching story. And let us know what you find. All right, everyone. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate your time. Make sure you check back for more videos on movies and stuff like that. Oh, go check out Noah. He's got his own little gaming series. So go watch that. There's going to be more videos out this week. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a great day.